If you played multiplayer at all in the past few days on DOS House, I'm sure you've run into plenty of combat shotguns, and I am also guilty of it. I've been told that this thing might get nerfed. I have a feeling it might get nerfed just because every single player in the game is using it. So why would I miss out on the fun? Because today we're beginning our combat shotgun gold. Now, really quick, here is my camo progress on the combat shotgun. I have every single thing done except for Death Artist. We need to get 8 more headshots with these specific attachments, the 18-inch precision barrel, 16-gauge 10-round drum, and what proficiency is it? I hate that it scrolls. Vital proficiency. Now, what I think Sledgehammer should do, and we've talked about this in a few videos, but for all these camo challenges, we have to have specific attachments equipped. There should be a button here in this camo category that equips them for you. It'd be like, just click here to apply these attachments. I think that would be a great quality of life change instead of going back and forth and back and forth. I figure out which ones you have, and a lot of these attachments have similar names, so sometimes you play a whole game with the wrong attachment on and not get any of that progress. I just think that'd be a huge help for our camo grinders out here. But this challenge, not too bad. Just need to get 8 headshots. Hopefully the spread is nice to us and we can get some headshots. I think we might be able to knock this out in one game. But I think probably the hardest challenge for this was long range kills. Long range kills are awful with a shotgun, but what I did, I think I might still have the class. No, I don't, but I can remake it. So what you want to do if you're struggling with those long range kills is you're going to want to put on the Framble 23-inch barrel. So toss that on there. Also, what I like to do is throw on any 2x sight. So the 2.5x sight works fine. This just helps me focus on getting long shots more, seeing that I have a larger sight on my weapon. Then when we come over here to stock, you're going to put on the Framble big game stock. This helps with your initial accuracy, making your first shot more accurate. So I like this a lot for going for long shots. Buck and slug are pretty decent to get this done, but if you don't have this unlocked, you can go ahead and throw on just the normal slug rounds or even the packed power rounds if you have these unlocked. Those all help with damage range. Steady also works pretty well for this. And then if you're still trying to level it up here on your kit, having surplus gives you 1 extra kill XP. So that's pretty good. Help you level it up faster. And then obviously put on as much ammo as you can when you can. And then the best grip for this is the smile pistol grip, or the SMLE pistol grip. So yeah, those are just some attachments that help me with long shots. And I think that's basically the hardest thing to get done with this weapon. I would highly suggest getting these done as soon as possible because of the upcoming nerf, or the suspected upcoming nerf. But let's go ahead, hop into game and see if we can get 8 headshots. All right, we're on the shotgun playground and we're already dead. We literally just spawned in. We're in a game in progress here. So hopefully we can still squeeze in 8 and we don't have to play 2 separate games, but we are already getting dominated. It's our first day out here. There's also another glitch going around where you can put on developer clan tags. So that's pretty cool. The first time I saw that, I was like, oh dang, I'm actually playing against developers. Turns out I wasn't. Just a bunch of people that can glitch that on. But, you know, they do look pretty cool. I'm sure they wouldn't be seen very often. So I'd rather have more visual glitches, like with the camo glitch, where you can apply the camo to any weapon, and the clan tag glitch over, like, guns being completely busted, the game not working right. Like, these are things that could be more easily ironed out than huge gameplay mechanics. Like, the shotguns are pretty busted at the moment. Like, they've done weapon adjustments before, so it shouldn't be too hard to fix it. At least I hope so, because it is very, very ridiculous trying to do any other weapon besides a shotgun right now. I was trying to get point blanks on this map for my SMGs. Was not happening. They were not having it. I could not get within an inch of somebody, within a few feet of somebody, really, because it was just constant just shotguns going off. But these guys look like they're already starting to learn the map. They're getting some spawn traps in. I need these headshots. I just can't get any in. As much as I want to start shooting down these spy planes, we have a mission here. There we go. That's a headshot. As long as we get a few. And I think our reticles are finally changed. Actually, is that it? I think we just got it. That last shot might have been gold right there. So we're at 45 then. Because for this one, it goes up every 5 headshots, I'm pretty sure, or something like that. So we need 1 more camo. Kind of weird that within 5 kills, you can get 2 camos, but... but, you know, I'm not complaining. At least not that much. Also recording this at 3 in the morning. So, nothing but sweats on. This is the sweat hour. Come on. That's a headshot. Just need a few more of those. Please. Oh, come on. It feels like nowhere safe on this map. I don't know where to go on here. I try to run through mid and get into here. And then the second I peek, there's another guy waiting, watching that angle. I guess we got through pretty clean there and just missed a few shots, but... it's hard to get anywhere, especially when somebody has map control. Like when the other team has map control, it's almost impossible to go anywhere. Spawn traps are just disgusting. And I'm sure shipment's not going to be any better. But at least when you're on the giving end and not the receiving end of a spawn trap, you can just rack up camos, rack up kills. I mean, if you're gonna give it, you gotta take it sometimes. Pause. Oh, come on. I'm just gonna not sprint with this thing at all. I think that's the best course of action here. And I'm already dead again. Come on. The guy's name is Lobby Control, and he's definitely controlling this lobby with 92 kills. And I think they did fix the thing with the riot shield where you can get shot in the back now, and it just blocks your bullets. So that's pretty cool. Everyone's running shotgun, riot shield, surviving for 5.5 hours, not getting touched. We're having a shotgun apocalypse here in Vanguard multiplayer. I gotta be like 1 or 2 headshots away. And this game is about to end. Oh, did we get a headshot there to end it, though? Did I get on Team MVP for leaving or getting this game way late? I don't think I did. Yep, did not happen. All right, let's see how close we got. We got to be less than 3 away. That's my guess. 2 away. Okay, so we were pretty on par there. We just need to get 2 headshots and then back out. Okay, hopefully we can get these 2 headshots quick and get out of here, because I don't need another spanking from these shotguns. I really don't. It's looking like the consensus on a lot of these like earlier camos before masteries, this nice white, pink, and blue camo is the way to go. I'm seeing a lot of people putting this camo on. So it's looking like this is definitely a fan favorite. All right, I'm gonna literally walk around ADS. I think that helps my pellet spread, meaning better headshot potential, hopefully. Oh, that guy's crazy. Where's a headshot? Is that one? No. Come on. What do I have on here? Wider pellet spread? Let's make this a tighter pellet spread. I'll change next time I spawn. Guess what? I'm spawning now. All right, let's try this out. Hopefully this helps. Jeez, this guy was right on me. There's 2 guys right on me. Why am I spawning right next to 2 people? That's a headshot. We need 1 more, I think. Unless we got one accidentally earlier. Oh, are they already calling in a nuke? We need a headshot now. Please, please, please. I can't be camo cursed here. Come on. Just one headshot is all I need. Is that it? No, that wasn't a headshot. Jeez. Okay, maybe that wasn't a nuke. I don't know why everything's on fire, though. It's really lagging the hell out of my game. Please, just one headshot. That's all I need. Is that it? Nope. Why can't I shoot somebody in the head? No, it's already over. We're definitely getting the camo curse here today. Come on. Good thing I only left 8 on the board. If I left 15 for us to do for a video, we'd be here all day. My God, I actually am only 1 away. How do I get 1 headshot? Please let me get 1. All right, 1 headshot. I think we can do it. Knock on wood. Please come through that door. Not looking like they're doing it. Let's bust through over here. Anybody? Okay, I should have turned right instead of left. I thought they might have already pushed forward. I thought we were already flipping spawns, but nope. He's just a headshot. That's all I need. Are you kidding me? He's riot shielded out. Just 1. Do me a favor. Give me a solid. Let me get 1 headshot. There we go. Is that it? We ranked up. Challenge completed. Challenge completed. Everything. Show me gold. Blood splatter. There we go. Another gold down. Let's go. People are pleading in chat to stop with the shotguns just for 1 game, but sorry, pal. I'll head out just for you. All right, let's go ahead and take a look at what the combat shotgun looks like with gold camo on it. Ah, that's beautiful. That is so nice. I gotta say that the camos in this game have knocked it out of the park. Just a lot of the basic camos going up to the masteries, and then the masteries just look real great. I think diamond needs a little fix, but besides that, these are amazing. This gold is so nice. The accents on it work together so well. The black and gold is just a really, really nice combo. Let's look at diamond. Here is diamond. You can see it kind of looks like stained glass the way it's shattered right there. This looks a lot nicer than a lot of the diamonds look. I feel like since it's a bigger weapon, or maybe it's more zoomed out, the diamonds look more like diamonds than they do thumbtacks. Maybe not on the stock, but if we could just get an updated diamond texture, this will be beautiful. And then of course the atomic camo, which looks great on everything in my opinion. This thing is amazing. Now you can see the 2 different color patterns of atomic on this weapon. Like on spots like here and here, you can really see the darker purple show up. And then on these spots, it's more the yellow and orange and all that moving around. I think this camo is absolutely beautiful. But let's go ahead and check in-game to see what this combat shotgun looks like with gold. All right, here is what the combat shotgun looks like in-game with gold. This thing is beautiful. You don't see a whole lot of gold close up, but the accent color is very nice. You can see the gold pop out on the whatever this thing is called. Every time you shoot, it'll fling back. That whole area is gold, which is pretty cool. The trigger here is also gold. It's just so nice. I think the camos look amazing in this game. And on this Modern Warfare engine with this castle lighting, it's just beautiful. Like, come on. Look at this gold shimmer. I'm so glad we got this done. Anyways, I think that's gonna do it for today's video. I just wanted to get this shotgun out of the way, at least one of them. So later on, if these things are nerfed in the ground, it's not that difficult for me to get done. But that's where we're gonna end today's video. So if you guys like this and you wanna see more, go ahead and leave a like on it. If you didn't, you don't dislike. If you're new here, please consider subscribing. Put out all kinds of COD content throughout the week. That's gonna be it for me today. I'll see you guys next time. Later.